As we have been studying these end time prophecies for these last days, we can see that there is much confusion coming from all sides due to all the false, self-proclaimed ministers who are nothing more than wolves, deceivers, and blind leaders of the blind. Many in the world truly believe that there is a third coming and have been taught that there is a third coming. But as we have learned from the scriptures, that there is no such thing as a third coming. Just as Christ had left the earth and went to heaven, he will return in like manner, and all his reward will also be with him. Acts chapter 1, verse 11 says,
"Ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? This same Jesus which is taken up from you into heaven shall so come in like manner as ye have seen him go into heaven."
And so, just as Christ left the earth, went into the clouds, and then into the third heaven, so Christ will return in the same manner, which will happen after probation soon closes, Revelation chapter 22, verse 11, which then the four winds from the four corners of the earth will be released, Revelation chapter 7, verses 1 through 5. Thus the wicked who have received the mark of the beast will be punished, Revelation chapter 16, and destroyed at the brightness of the Lord's appearing at the end of the seventh plague, 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 8. And at the end of the seventh plague, Christ will then appear with all his reward with him, Revelation chapter 22, verse 12.
"And behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me, to give every man according as his work shall be."
Isaiah 40, verse 10.
"Behold, the Lord God will come with strong hand, and his arm shall rule for him. Behold, his reward is with him, and his work before him."
When Christ appears the second time at the end of the seventh plague, his reward is with him. This is where John saw the kingdom of God coming down with Christ to meet his bride, the saints of the Most High, the children of God, to rapture them up into the clouds to receive their eternal reward in the kingdom of God. This is where the Bible says clearly and proclaims in Revelation chapter 21, verse 2 and 3.
"And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God."
And so, at Christ's appearing, all the holy city of God will be with him. Christ will call forth the saints out of their dusty graves then. Then the saints will come forth from their dusty graves to then be with the 144,000 living saints who did not taste death, but had the pleasure of being sealed to venture through the seven last plagues. Then all the saints will then be raptured up into the clouds together to forever be with the Lord in the New Jerusalem, which is when the saints will receive the reward. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 16 and 17.
"For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord."
And so, in this small prophecy chart, which we will build upon this prophecy chart in this video, we will first understand that we must watch and keep our garments before probation closes. While probation is open, we must do all that we can to stand in everything that comes our way that the enemy will send. This is where the 1 hour with the beast, the Sunday laws, the death decree, and everything will take place during this time. And in this time, we are going to be deciding our eternal destiny and what reward we will receive when Christ comes his second time. This is where we have Revelation chapter 22, verse 12. So now, let us break down this reward that Christ is bringing with him at his appearing. In the word reward, the Strong's Concordance says, in number 3408, it is said, misthos, which means pay for service, literally or figuratively, good or bad, higher reward wages. And so, with that said, the bad, the wicked, the unrepentant sinners will receive their reward. And the good, the children of God, the heaven-bound Christians, will also receive their reward. And now let's look at the two classes. First, for the wicked, we see their reward, which is first found in Revelation chapter 16, where you have the seven last plagues. And Revelation 18, verse 6 says,
reward her even as she rewarded you, and double unto her double according to her works. In the cup which she hath filled, fill to her double.
Hebrews chapter 2.
For if the word spoken by angels was steadfast, and every transgression and disobedience received a just recompense of reward, how shall we escape if we neglect so great salvation?
Then we see that the reward will partake of eternal death. 2 Thessalonians chapter 1, verses 7 through 10.
And to you who are troubled, rest with us, when the Lord Jesus shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels, in flaming fire, taking vengeance on them that know not God and that obey not the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, who shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of the Lord and from the glory of his power, when he shall come to be glorified in his saints and to be admired in all them that believe, because our testimony among you was believed in that day.
Matthew chapter 3, verse 12.
Whose fan is in his hand, and he will thoroughly purge his floor and gather his wheat into the garner, but he will burn up the chaff with unquenchable fire.
Proverbs chapter 1, verse 27 and 28.
When your fear cometh as desolation, and your destruction cometh as a whirlwind, when distress and anguish cometh upon you, then shall they call upon me, but I will not answer. They shall seek me early, but they shall not find me.
2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 8.
And then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth, and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming.
Malachi chapter 4.
For behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven, and all the proud, yea, and all that do wickedly, shall be stubble. And the day that cometh shall burn them up, saith the Lord of hosts, that it shall leave them neither root nor branch. And ye shall tread down the wicked, for they shall be ashes under the soles of your feet in the day that I shall do this, saith the Lord of hosts.
Daniel chapter 2, verse 35.
Then was the iron, the clay, the brass, the silver, and the gold broken to pieces together, and became like the chaff of the summer threshing floors, and the wind carried them away, that no place was found for them.
Revelation chapter 20, verse 14 and 15.
And death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. And whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire.
And Revelation chapter 20, verse 9.
And they went up on the breadth of the earth and compassed the camp of the saints about and the beloved city, and fire came down from God out of heaven and devoured them.
And when you look at what the Lord says in his scriptures regarding the state of the wicked, when they are finally put to death in the second resurrection, when they are judged unworthy of eternal life, you can see that they will burn and burn forever and ever in hellfire until both root and branch are destroyed. They will not be living in hellfire for eternity, but they will be eternally destroyed forever and ever. Now let's take a look at the reward for the saints. When Christ shall come the second time, at his appearing, the reward will be given to the saints as followed. Colossians chapter 3, verse 24.
Knowing that of the Lord ye shall receive the reward of the inheritance, for ye serve the Lord Christ.
Their inheritance will be, number one, the kingdom of God. Matthew chapter 25, verse 34.
Then shall the king say unto them on his right hand, Come, ye blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world.
Number 2, the reward when Christ shall appear will be eternal life. Matthew chapter 19, verse 29.
And every one that hath forsaken houses, or brethren, or sisters, or father, or mother, or wife, or children, or lands, for my name's sake, shall receive an hundredfold, and shall inherit everlasting life.
The saints will then inherit the earth, where it will be made new. Matthew chapter 5, verse 5.
Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth.
Isaiah chapter 60, verse 21.
Thy people also shall be all righteous. They shall inherit the land forever, the branch of my planting, the work of my hands, that I may be glorified.
And number 4, the saints will receive a throne. 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 8.
He raiseth up the poor out of the dust, and lifteth up the beggar from the dunghill, to set them among princes, and to make them inherit the throne of glory.
On the throne, the saints will judge. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 1 through 3.
Dare any of you, having a matter against another, go to law before the unjust, and not before the saints? Do ye not know that the saints shall judge the world? And if the world shall be judged by you, are ye unworthy to judge the smallest matters? Know ye not that we shall judge angels? How much more things that pertain to this life?
They will also become kings and priests, and they will reign. Revelation chapter 5, verse 10.
And hast made us unto our God kings and priests, and we shall reign on the earth.
Number 5. Mansions. They will receive their mansions, their dwelling place in heaven. John chapter 14, verse 2 through 4.
In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know.
Number 6. They will be called the children of God. Luke chapter 6, verse 35.
But love ye your enemies, and do good, and lend, hoping for nothing again. And your reward shall be great, and ye shall be the children of the highest. For he is kind unto the unthankful and to the evil.
And number 7, the children of God will be made equal with the angels. Luke chapter 20, verse 36.
Neither can they die any more, for they are equal unto the angels, and are the children of God, being the children of the resurrection.
And so, the reward of heaven is coming with Christ, and it will be here at his appearing at the end of the seventh plague, which the saints of the Most High will inherit the kingdom of God at that point, and the wicked, unrepentant sinners will receive their just eternal reward in the end for destroying the earth with their lives.
Saying, We give thee thanks, O Lord God Almighty, which art and wast and art to come, because thou hast taken to thee thy great power and hast reigned. And the nations were angry, and thy wrath is come, and the time of the dead that they should be judged, that thou shouldest give reward unto thy servants the prophets, and to the saints, and them that fear thy name, small and great, and shouldest destroy them which destroy the earth.
Okay, so now, when you look at this prophecy chart, which we call the coming of Christ, and his reward is with him, you can see that in this place here, before probation closes, is where we are deciding our eternal destiny and reward. This is where everything is going to take place that is going to again decide our future reward when Christ comes and appears the second time. So when probation closes, as Revelation chapter 22 verse 11 proclaims, the four winds of Revelation chapter 7 verses 1 through 5 will be released. The time of trouble for the wicked will begin in the seven last plagues, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And at the end of the seventh plague, Jesus will appear in the clouds, and at the brightness of his coming, at his appearing, he will call forth the sleeping saints to be with then the 144,000, and where Christ will ultimately destroy the wicked who still remain, where the righteous will be raptured up together into the clouds and receive their reward in the clouds in the kingdom of God, where they will reside for 1,000 years to judge the wicked. This is where the saints again receive the reward. The kingdom of God, where God's throne is at, will be above the earth, where the earth will be his footstool. Then, at the end of the 1,000 years, where the second resurrection will take place, when Christ calls forth the dead wicked, where they will come forth to meet the judgment, the great white throne judgment of the Lord Jesus Christ. They will be found guilty. Satan will then go to the four corners of the earth where his kingdoms were at, where he will deceive the nations one last time to go to the city of God to take the tree of life, to steal it. They cannot repent from their evil works, and they want the tree of life so that they can live forever in their sinful lives. When this is done, hellfire will proceed from heaven to destroy the wicked, as Revelation chapter 20 proclaims. When the hellfire burns them forever and ever until both root and branch, soul and body are destroyed, then they'll be made ashes under the soles of our feet, and we will come out of the city of God to reign on the earth with Christ in the new heaven and the new earth. When you look at this, we can understand and know that when Christ comes a second time, his reward is with him, as Revelation chapter 22 verse 12 proclaims. This prophecy chart is just, true, and faithful, and I pray that you will share this to everyone and everyone that you can. Peace be unto you this day. Amen.